This is Mr. Wearsome, and the book I read is The Book Thief. You know The Book Thief's author, Marcus Zusak, because he is the same man who wrote I Am the Messenger, the book we enjoyed at the beginning of the year. Taking a look at the postmodern themes in this novel, the themes I saw most distinctly were irony and black humor, intertextuality, and fragmentation and chaos. First, let's take a look at irony and black humor. I see this theme present because the novel is narrated by a personification of death. The funny thing is that death is not creepy or scary. Just the opposite is true. Death is, perhaps, the most compassionate character. To prove my point, take a look at this quote from Death. I am haunted by humans. Of course, it is ironic because usually death haunts us. But because it takes place in Nazi Germany, as we'll get to in a minute, here death is haunted and horrified by humans, by how cruel we can be. The second postmodern theme is appropriation and intertextuality. Let's take a look at appropriation. I can't help but think about the character of Death from Ingmar Bergman's 1957 movie, The Seventh Seal. In this movie, Death appears as a personification. Look how scary he looks with his black robe and skull-like face. The basic plot of this movie involves a knight who comes back from the Crusades and challenges Death to a chess match, hanging in the balance, his very life. This idea of Death personified was picked up in Bill and Ted's Bogus Journey. Bill and Ted challenge Death to many different games, and they get funnier and funnier. First, they challenge Death to a game of Battleship. Of course, Bill and Ted win, and I love the part where they defeat Death. Of course, Death is not happy, and he says, "Hit! You have sunk my battleship!" Death is not satisfied, and Bill and Ted challenge him to Clue. Death again doesn't do very well, guessing Colonel Mustard. He loses because it was really Mr. Plum. Then they try magnetic football, and Death is terrible at that, and so he scatters the players. Their final game is a game of Twister. You know how it's going to end. Death is going to lose. You have these books and movies about Death being silly or not good at games, and in The Book Thief, he is a compassionate one. I think of all the characters in the book, I appreciate Death the most. The next theme is fragmentation and chaos. And of course there'll be fragmentation and chaos, because it takes place in Nazi Germany, especially when it comes to the book burnings. The Nazis used to burn books they thought were dangerous or filled with Jewish propaganda, and they would have the Hitler Youth throw in the books and join in these horrible bonfires. The main character in The Book Thief is Liesel Memminger. She is part of the Hitler Youth, but not because she wants to. She has to. All the children are required to join. They had very little choice. And it is at one of these book burnings where she pulls out a book still hot and smoldering. She's a book thief for many reasons, and that is one of them. Another interesting character, and an integral part of the book, is Max Vandenberg. He's a Jewish as well as a fighter, a fist fighter, like a boxer. And he comes over to the Huberman house where Liesel lives and nearly dies, going into a coma-like state for many days. Liesel reads to him, and Max does finally get better. As I said, Liesel is staying with Hans Huberman, but he is not her dad. He's her foster father. Liesel's an orphan. Her mother is God knows where, and her brother's died, so little 9-year-old Liesel is given to the Hubermans. Hans Huberman, there on the left, is just so kind. It's a very tender relationship. There was a movie made of this book in 2013. It looks wonderful. There's Max, a Jewish friend, hiding in the basement. Liesel reads to him, and she steals books. She breaks into a library. The family lives in constant danger because they hide Max in the basement. It looks like such a beautiful movie. The scenes of the book burning are shown there. Liesel stealing that hot, smoldering book. The critics are quoted at the end of the trailer that it was brilliant and a major achievement. But how good was the movie? I haven't seen it yet, but Rotten Tomato critics have it a green splat with only 47% of the critics giving it good marks. But look at how the audience loved it. 73% of the audience gave it great marks. One of the interesting things in this trailer is that the actor who plays Hans Huberman, well, that's Jeffrey Rush. I just love Jeffrey Rush, and you might remember him as Captain Barbossa in The Pirates of the Caribbean. And what a great theme song from that movie. I could just listen to that music all day and then go outside and swap the deck, put a patch in my eye and call you matey. Go out and buy a parrot for my shoulder. What a great song. One interesting thing I discovered while doing the research for this video was the sheer volume of information and images and drawings in The Book Thief. Cartoons and drawings, and animated figures, and Then I went over to the memes that came from the novel. There are some beautiful quotes pulled from the book because Marcus Zusak can be such a poetic writer. For instance, he writes, "Sometimes people are beautiful, but not in looks, not in what they say, just in what they are." Also, he writes, "He does something to me, that boy, every time. It's his only detriment. He steps on my heart. He makes me cry." Finally, this book is a good example of postmodern literature, and if you take a look at this drawing, it shows how in pre-modernity, the world is fixed because God put it there and that's the way it's always been. In the modern period of onwards and upwards with inevitable progress, and then of course there's postmodernity, there's just chaos. I want to leave you with the final concept of postmodernity in this book, that of both and. Something can be two things at once. Something can have opposites coming together. To illustrate that, look at this quote. "I'm always finding humans at their best and worst. I see their ugly and their beauty, and I wonder how the same thing can be both." Do you have any idea who said that in The Book Thief? I hope by now you do. It's the most compassionate of all the characters, the character of death. I recommend The Book Thief, written by Marcus Zusak, the same author of I Am the Messenger, the book we enjoyed at the beginning of the year.